Good morning children. So in the last class we discussed about the landform plateau. So in today's class we are going to discuss about the landform plains. So what are plains here? So plains are a flat land with a gentle slopes. Okay, once again, plains are the flat lands with gentle slopes. So we can see the plains near the mountains areas. Okay, so the rivers flowing from the mountains, so the rivers which flow from the mountains, okay, so it brings the fertile soil to the plains. Okay, so the river water when it goes on flowing down, so it brings the fertile soil to the plains here. So crops grow well here. So where there is a fertile soil, where there is a good soil, so it is a good source of cultivating the plant, the trees, okay, the agriculture. So wherever we find a good soil, so there we can do a good agriculture there. Okay, so we can grow many crops, right? So plains are therefore the most thickly populated area in the world. So as we are having all the resources near the plains, that is we are having water and very good fertile soil for the agriculture. So near the plains we can see the many people living near the plains. Okay, so mostly we see the plains are totally filled with the thickly populated. So many of the people live near the plains, right? So children, so these are the plains, right? See here. So as the river water will get the fertile soil to the plains, so it is easy for us to grow the crops here. Now next is the deserts. Now what is a desert here? Deserts are large, extremely dry area of land. So as you see here, so a desert are a vast area of land. It is very dry. It is totally covered with the dry sand. Okay, so there is a very little rainfall and very few plants grow in the deserts. Okay, so as it is very dry, as we are not having much rainfall there, so only few plants are grown in the desert. Okay, so you can see here, you can see the camel. So camel is called as a sheep of the desert. Why? Because it can easily move in the dry soil, in the dry sand. Okay, so that's why most of the people there will use the camel to move from one place to another place in the desert. So that's why we call the camel as a sheep of the desert. Okay, so in the summer season the days are very hot. Even though not only in the summer, in the throughout the days also it is very hot in the deserts. Okay, so due to less amount of rainfall, right? So and it's an interesting thing that the days are very much hot and in the night time it becomes totally cool. Okay, it becomes in the night times the deserts will be very cool, just because the soil won't catches the heat for the long time. Okay, so that's why in the night time the deserts become totally cool. In winters the days are cool and the nights are also very cool. Okay, so in the winters or in the winter season the day is cool and the night are much cooler than the daytime, right? So let us see some important deserts throughout the world. So the first one is the Sahara Desert, which is situated in the North Africa. So it is the biggest desert in the world. The Sahara Desert is the biggest desert in the world. The next is the Kalahari Desert, which is situated in the southern part of the Africa. Okay, which is situated in the southern part of the Africa, Kalahari Desert. The next is the Atacama Desert. So it is situated in the South America. Then next, the desert of our country, the Thar Desert, which is situated in India. Okay, so today we have learned about the landform, the plains. Okay, the plains are the flat lands with the gentle slopes, and also we have learned about the deserts. So in the next class we are going to discuss about the another landform. Okay children, hope you understood about this topic. Thank you.